Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Puthilam, in my YouTube channel, My Intuition. This is an overview of structure of atoms. Atoms are the building blocks of matter. They are the smallest part of an element that chemically react. The first atomic theory was proposed by John Dalton in 1808, regarded atom as the ultimate indivisible particle of matter. His theory was based on law of conservation of mass and law of constant composition. Towards the end of 19th century, it was proved experimentally that atoms are divisible and consist of three fundamental particles, namely electrons, protons, and neutrons. The discovery of these subatomic particles led to the proposal of various atomic models to explain the structure of atom. J.J. Thomson in 1898 proposed that an atom consists of uniform sphere of positive charge with electrons embedded into it. And his model, the mass of the atom is considered to be evenly spread over the atom. His model was compared to that of watermelon or plum pudding, raisin pudding, in which, say, take the example of watermelon, the juicy part is the positive charge and the seed are considered as the electrons. J.J. Thomson's model was proved wrong by Rutherford's famous alpha particle scattering experiment conducted in 1909. And Rutherford concluded that atom is made of tiny positively charged nucleus at its center with electrons revolving around it in circular orbits. It resembled that of a solar system. As per Maxwell's electromagnetic theory, charged particles on acceleration emits electromagnetic radiation. Therefore, if an electron is moving in a circular path, that means that electron or charged particle, the matter or the particle, it is changed direction. Any particle, if it changes its velocity or changes direction, that causes the acceleration. So if the acceleration is of that of a charged particle, then it will be emitting electromagnetic radiation and the electron should go in a spiral way and it should combine with the nucleus. So the theoretical calculation says that it will take not more than 10 to the power minus 8 seconds for an electron to collapse and join with that of nucleus. Therefore, Rutherford failed to explain the stability of atoms and the distribution and relative energies of electrons around the nucleus. These difficulties of Rutherford model were overcome by Niels Bohr in 1930 with his model with hydrogen atom. Bohr postulated that electron moves around the nucleus in circular orbits. Only certain orbits can exist and each orbit corresponds to a specific energy. And he introduced the series like Lyman series, Balmer series, Paschen series, Brackett series, and Pufan series. And Bohr even able to calculate exactly the distance between the electrons and nucleus. In 1916, Arnold Sommerfeld proposed modifications to Bohr model. In addition to the principal quantum number, he introduced azimuthal quantum number L, say that each shell is subdivided into subshells named S, P, D, F, and the magnetic quantum number, which defined the orientation of the subshell in space. And also a spin also was considered. Arnold Sommerfeld was nominated for a Nobel Prize more than 48 times, but he never selected for Nobel Prize. Almost all of his students are selected for Nobel Prize. His students continued the work. Before that, dual nature of matter was proposed by de Broglie in 1923. In Bohr model, electron is regarded as a charged particle moving in a well-defined circular orbit about the nucleus. Only the electron was considered as a particle, but any particle, it behaves as waves also. Therefore, the wave character of the electron is ignored in Bohr's theory. In 1925, Wolfgang Pauli announced the exclusion principle. That is the famous Pauli's exclusion principle. It states that no two electrons in an atom can have the same set of four quantum numbers. The same year, Frederick Hund proposed Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity, which states that pairing of electrons in the orbitals belonging to the same subshell does not take place until each orbital belonging to that subshell has got one electron each. that is, it is singly occupied. Werner Heisenberg, with the famous uncertainty principle in 1927, concluded that it is difficult or impossible to precisely identify the position and velocity of a particle. So if you say an orbit, that means it is a defined path, or it defined with the position and velocity of electron at the same time, but it is not possible as per uncertainty principle. Therefore, later Erwin Schrodinger in 1926 proposed an equation called Schrodinger equation to describe the electron distribution in space and allowed energy levels in atoms. All the electron distribution and their allowed energy levels were explained by Schrodinger. This equation incorporates de Broglie's concept of wave particle duality, as well as it is inconsistent with Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. So he called it as quantum mechanical model. It explained for hydrogen atoms successfully, predicting all the hydrogen atom spectrum, including some phenomena that was not able to explain by Bohr model. So all these forms are the basis of electronic structure of atom, from Dalton's model, Thomson's model, Rutherford model, Bohr model, to the quantum mechanical model by Schrodinger. Therefore, quantum mechanical model says that it is an electron cloud or orbitals and having different shapes, the electron movements or the subshells having different shapes for that of S, P, D and E. Thank you very much for watching my video. Please do subscribe my YouTube channel and support. Once again, thank you very much and have a nice day.